Every year, EC Vision holds its annual Customer Advisory Board meeting. It's a great opportunity for us to network together and for EC Vision to show some of our innovative products and the roadmap for our customers. Over the years, we've been at different locations, New York City, Las Vegas, Orlando, and just last year in New Orleans, we decided to come to the Las Vegas of Asia. So here we are today at the Venetian Macau. I've spent the last 3 days with our customers, and we've had the opportunity to talk more about them and why they use EC Vision. So why don't you come along and listen to what they have to say. First interview is Manny Fernandez, the CTO of Lianfeng Group. So Manny, how many years have you been working with EC Vision, and has this been an incremental relationship?
Thanks, Gary. We've been working with EC Vision since 2007, so the last 7 years. And for sure, every year it's completely incremental. We've been growing the use of the product, expanding the geography that we roll out to, and the functionality.
Did you start with a certain geographic region and then and strategically and then decide to move to other regions?
Sure. I mean, when we first started, it was a specific case. We were piloting it. We did it for a specific business in a specific geography. It was that successful that we quickly rolled out within 8 months to our whole geography. So we rolled out to all our businesses in every geography we operate in.
And the user base is made up of both internal and external teams. What's the mix, basically?
Well, no, in this case, we actually integrated with our back-end ERPs, and we focused on using the product to be our vendor and supplier base focus. So predominantly, it's to do all tasks for, it's our only window to our suppliers and vendors, which previously was quite fragmented for us, quite paper-based, quite laborious. With EC Vision solution, we're able to put functions online, and now nearly all functions online of the communications between suppliers, factories, and ourselves.
So everyone implements a technology solution in order to get a return on investment.
Sure.
So you hinted to what yours is. Without giving specific numbers, what terms do you really look at when you're quantifying an investment like EC Vision?
Sure. I mean, typically, when we're doing other ERPs or solutions, you look at what the ROI is. When we actually did the EC Vision solution, there was a gap in the market for us. It was a labor-intensive job. We didn't look at initially the cost. However, having said that, since then, our return investment has been X-fold. It's from year one we were benefiting not only in productivity gains. Our company grows very, very quickly. Our transactions have grown very quickly. And because of that, with the EC Vision product in, we've not had to linearly grow with manpower to operate it. On top of that, we've actually seen our factory and supplier base also feedback that they're doing lower transactional costs as well. So we've actually taken money out of the supply chain on both sides, not just for ourselves, but for our factories and vendors.
That's great. I know that you're a huge proponent of EC Vision, and anytime we ask you for a recommendation, you're one of the first to do that. If you would recommend EC Vision to another brand, retailer, an agent, what type of recommendation would you make and why?
You're right, I'm doing this quite often. I also quite critical in areas where you guys don't perform, but in areas where I do recommend, as a productivity tool, and its usability, I think it's fantastic. And I think for us, when we rolled out, we provided a small functional case, and we rolled it out very widely, and we were very successful with that, as opposed to picking a whole, you know, every part of the supply chain and try and roll out for a few customers. So I really recommend, you know, especially with the tool set you have, that to pick a pilot case, a limited set of functionality and roll that out, that you'll soon find it scales very, very easily, and you can grow very, very quickly, as we did.
That's great advice. One thing you talk about, the number of suppliers that are coming online using EC Vision. One of the differentiators we like to point out in the marketplace is that we have great customer support teams that are located in Asia. So can you tell me about your experience with our support teams and how they've worked for your suppliers and your internal teams?
Sure. I mean, being a Hong Kong or Asia-based multinational, it's one of the things that attracted us to EC Vision, because we were really a big part of our processes are with the factories and vendors. So for us, using the product and having local support is primary, and development as well. So we actually find that that's great. But we also have factories all around the world. And one of the nice things about the product right now is, for us, the way we rolled it out and the way the product operates, it's so easy to use that actually support is secondary. You know, we actually have, when we first started rolling out, we only had email support to our vendors. To this date, we still only need to do that. It's not like any other ERP we roll out. We actually find support levels are very low. So we tend to go to you guys for more technical support than actually functional support.
Okay, it's all great to hear. Last question. You're here at our Customer Advisory Board for 2014. What made you want to come? Were you looking to learn something that that's a challenge for you moving ahead into 2014, 2015?
Yeah, I mean, we've been a big user for a long time. I'm now looking at the new functionality that's coming out. I'm very keen to see what you guys are doing, especially around the content side of it and the collaboration tool sets. So we're very keen to start expanding our footprint and functions. Okay. So to look at that. And also really the amount of other retailers and customers you have here now, it's grown exponentially. And now these are some of our customers as well. So it's actually great to catch up with them and see how many other people are using your product.
Great. Thanks. Any other comments?
No, that's about all I have, but thanks for having me here.
Thank you.
Thanks, Gary.
Okay. So Chuck, welcome to Customer Advisory Board 2014, and I know this isn't your first CAB with us. How many years have you been working with EC Vision, and which companies?
I think this year is probably 10th year, okay. Something like 2004. That was with Saks Department Stores. And then I think I've been to 5 or 6 CABs, so between Saks and Bon-Ton, and then now with Brown Shoe Company.
Great. And so with Brown Shoe, you kind of brought EC Vision everywhere you went.
True.
And with Brown Shoe, what has been the primary project that EC Vision has been doing for you?
It's really the same thing that we've done at each of the companies where we've implemented the software. We started with that interface between the factory shipping documents and our inbound logistics step. So one of the things that I think EC Vision has a particular strength in is replacing the manual documents that get created, the commercial invoices, the packing lists, and doing all that electronically, allowing us to have those in a controlled manner so that we'd have minimal editing and then can make use of that information directly into our systems. That was really what was attractive to me in the beginning about EC Vision. That's the core competence. And that is where we started, both back at Saks and now at Brown Shoe. We started with that, replacing the paper with an electronic interface.
And
I know one of the biggest scores for EC Vision and Brown Shoe was that we are able to work with your SAP implementation for your purchase order collaboration. We've talked internally a lot about how the PO collaboration helps Brown Shoe with production planning in particular. So can you elaborate just a little on that?
Well, the benefit is more in execution than in planning. I mean, we do get benefit in planning, but when you say PO collaboration, what's happening is we're generating a purchase order in SAP, passing it through EC Vision out to the factory, so the factory doesn't have to be EDI compliant,
right,
and yet they are receiving the effect of an EDI transmission. We can control the way they view the information, make it look like a paper PO to them. And so that transmission of information from SAP through EC Vision is very useful for us. As we make changes, we're able to alert the factory that there has been a change. And so that ability to tell them something is new, that they need to go back and look at the record again, is very important. In the past, and for many other companies, that's a matter of an email, and we can do it through an alert. And then if the factory wants to request a change, historically, that's been a conversation or an email, and we built into the EC Vision, or you already had the functionality, we took advantage of it, the ability for the factory to request a change and for us to approve that in two different levels, an offshore approval and a U.S. approval. And then if the change is approved, for example, a new date, that date is automatically posted back into SAP. So we did the transmission of the purchase order, the transmission of changes, and then the request of changes from the factory and integrated all that into SAP very smoothly. And then the first area we talked about is the last step where the factory is about to ship, they produce their documents, they actually print their case labels on site in the factory, which for us was a big benefit, and then they're able to send the ASN effectively back into SAP. The case label printing was significant because we were using a third party for case label printing. And in many cases, these labels would be produced a week or two ahead of shipping. We were able to produce them in the factory with printers the factory bought. And this is very useful if there's a last-minute change or a modification to a purchase order. In the past, this would have created maybe a carton that wasn't scannable when it reached the States.
Right.
So if you look at benefits we've gotten, we're able to easily integrate with SAP. And we've gotten the benefit of controlled electronic documents and very short lead time on being able to produce the case labels.
And all this work has to yield some return on investment.
Right.
And without fully quantifying in numbers, I've heard you mention many different benefits. Okay, so if you could just kind of recap them. So first of all, your supplier portal.
Right.
It does what for you?
Well, we are on top of the communication of information with our factories in a much more timely way than is possible otherwise. We were able to take labor out of the process. In the past, our communication of purchase orders was PDFs sent through email. So the people that had to do that repetitively, they don't need to spend as much time doing it. There are fewer people doing that than there used to be.
Yep.
Most of those employees, we found something else for them to do, but we were able to reduce there. We actually charged the factory for the label.
Okay.
And allow them to print it on inexpensive stock where they were paying a fairly premium price because they're buying from a third party. And the third party was charging the price partially because they had systems integration that they had to do. So we were able to get a benefit there. In terms of the immediacy of our visibility into what's happening and our ability to respond to that, I'm sure that our on-time shipping rate has improved as a result of being able to cleanly communicate in both directions and to communicate change requests in either direction. So the on-time shipping is a real key. We've driven that up substantially the last couple of years, and EC Vision really is one of the key tools to getting there.
And you know, a Brown Shoe has a number of customers, and so I think that this gives your customers a level of confidence that you have the right systems in place to ensure that they're going to get their orders.
Yeah, it's hard to say whether they really realize that we have EC Vision in place.
Right.
We might talk about that. What they're really looking at is the results.
Right.
Because we're a much more reliable supplier in terms of on-time shipping, the fact that we have EC Vision makes us, it gives us benefit that we can then pass on to them in terms of better reliability.
With a tremendous supplier base in China and other regions in Asia, Is there a differentiator that EC Vision has that you think really, especially from the customer support side, that you guys have been able to tap into?
It's our offshore, the leadership of our sourcing operation is in South China. Mm-hmm. And it's very convenient that you guys are located in Shenzhen and Hong Kong. It's right. easy for us to get together and talk about during implementation, things that we need to work on. We're not doing conference calls, you know, late at night. So proximity is useful. The fact that you've got a help desk that speaks Chinese, very useful, and it's been very helpful with our vendors. So I think having a substantial part of your operation close to a substantial part of ours has been a benefit. We could have worked with you across the ocean. It's just more convenient that you're next door.
Right. Why do you keep coming back to EC Vision? Company after company, you obviously there's something that makes you come back to EC Vision, so why?
It's a great product. It works. Haven't found anything cheaper, and okay. you guys are fun to work with.
Great. Anything you want to add?
No, I think we've had a good working relationship for a long time, and I wouldn't have brought EC Vision into the company I'm with now if it wasn't the right fit.
Right.
It was precisely what we needed, and helped us. Really, we were able to create, if you think about what we've talked about, the transmission of purchase orders and the request in both direction, we've now been able to build on that. So we have factories telling us production schedules where before they simply accepted the PO and produced documents.
Right.
From the production schedules, we can then have visibility into whether they are ordering materials on time, which gives us the ability to work with the second tier suppliers in our supply chain and work with them substantively. We can get into detail with
right.
what about this order? Did you ship this on time? So we've been able to take the basics of what EC Vision provides and build on that and use it as a foundation piece. That's of great benefit because alternatively we might be working with three different software companies. So it's nice to be able to take that base and build on it and get the benefit we're getting.
Chuck, it's always good to see you. Thank you for doing the interview today.
Oh, my pleasure.
Okay. Good morning, and this is Carol Zimmerman with PVH Corporation. Carol, so how many years have you been coming to EC Vision CAP meetings?
So we've been working with EC Vision for 6 years, since 2008.
Great. And this is your fourth Customer Advisory Board meeting with us?
Yes.
Great. How did EC Vision and PVH first start their relationship together?
PVH was implementing PDM, and EC Vision had a partnership to build the integration to extend the functionality of PDM.
Okay. And so when we started working with you, it was through Gerber Web PDM.
Right.
And today, how have we grown through our relationship?
We've moved way beyond integration with PDM and extended our sourcing environment through EC Vision mm-hmm. onto the cloud and partnering with our external partners now. So it's gone way beyond what we initially started with.
Right. And so currently we have an initiative for material management.
Yes.
So what are the goals that PVH is looking for with this type of project?
So our biggest driving force is to move non-value-added work off of the PVH resources, all of the emails and data entry, and move that to our external partners who are the source of that information. So move those tasks to the source and free up the internal resources to become more exception-based as opposed to managing this information offline.
And that's been a recurring theme, I think, for all of the implementations EC Vision's done with PVH.
Yeah.
We started initially with a large costing implementation
right.
to simplify that. Reduce the workload internally and to streamline that.
And enhance the global communication with our internal partners in our hub offices offshore. We have offices in the United States, in Hong Kong, Honduras. We're opening up offices in Egypt, India, Africa, Sri Lanka, Shanghai, we have a big office in. So having that centralized portal of information across the globe instantly available has been enormous for us.
Right. And so return on investment is a huge thing. So there's a lot of time, effort, and money put into any software implementation. What types of terms are you looking for in return on investment, let's say from this project?
So part of it is a headcount reduction. Mm-hmm. Moving that work to our external partners, we won't need people to do all of that data entry and double check information and pass spreadsheets around. So we should have a headcount reduction on the business side. At the lower end, again, freeing up knowledge workers to focus on exceptions and improving our product development flow.
Right.
From an IT perspective, we've seen a pretty significant return on investment as far as the headcount needed to support our business partners, because the platform allows the business partners to instantly get visibility to their information by themselves and export it to Excel, pivot it, and provide analysis. So resources that we were dedicating to those activities just aren't needed anymore. It's a significant reduction in that effort from an IT perspective.
Right. And just a few years ago, we saw a huge growth spurt from PVH with the Tommy Hilfiger acquisition. And so does that mean then there's opportunities for continued growth for PVH, branching out with possibly more brands or delivering more for customers?
Absolutely. PVH is an acquisition kind of company. Between the time that we started with EC Vision and now, we not only acquired Tommy Hilfiger and integrated them into some of our platforms, but also the Warnaco brands, which covers Calvin Klein jeans, Calvin Klein underwear, Speedo North America, Olga and Warner,
right.
Intimate Apparel. So all of those brands have been added to the platform with really no disruption at all. So that's enormously scalable.
Right. So we're talking about huge efficiency and streamlining all of your projects, at the same time allowing for growth, scalable growth for the organization financially as well.
Right. Absolutely.
Great. Anything else to add about your relationship with EC Vision? What makes it unique and different from other technology partners?
I think...
Aside from being great people.
Incredibly good looking.
Yes.
I've worked with a lot of software companies, and I think this is a good partnership because it's truly a partnership. When you make a phone call with a problem, someone actually answers your phone call and addresses your problem. You're not dropping into an international abyss of an organization. It's a focused mid-size organization to work with that is motivated to build good partnerships with their customers.
Great. That's about it.
And this year, by the way, is the first time that we've hosted.
See you all. Thanks.
So we're just wrapping up on the 2014 EC Vision Customer Advisory Board here at the Venetian Macau. It's been an exciting 3 days for us and our customers, an opportunity for them to interact with each other, and more importantly, for us to show them the technology solutions we plan to deliver to help make their world easier. So until next time, have a great day. Bye-bye.